The Redmi 5A, the desh ka smartphone. Xiaomi's latest attempt to set the Indian budget market ablaze. Is it worth considering? Well, I wasn't a fan while unboxing this one, given I expected it to be priced at 6,000 rupees based on the 4A's price tag and the 5A's price tag in China. Now that the price has been revealed to be $1,000 cheaper, have my thoughts changed? Well, let's delve deeper. But before we do, if this is your first time here, or in case me speaking Hindi has your brain all mixed up, my name's Ash, you're watching C4E Tech, and if you do end up liking our review, please do show your support, give this video a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button and bell icons. Now, let's get to the review. So the Redmi 5A from China has received a few changes, you know, while making its way all over to India. For starters, it's got a secondary SIM slot. Well, it already did have a second SIM slot, but now it's got a secondary dedicated slot. It's not a hybrid, so we've got dedicated support for a second SIM and micro SD. Number two, Xiaomi's supposed to be using a dual graphite sheet layer to the back panel for better heat dissipation. Is it effective? Was that needed? You know, I can't really say because I didn't face any heating issues with the 5A, but then again, I didn't really face any heating issues with the 4A either, which for all intents and purposes has the same internals. Anyway, for the third change, it gets a 332 variant and that is priced at 6999. Do know that we got it as the 216 variant, and as always, let's start with the build quality. The Redmi 5A sports a plastic body without a premium feel or heft to it, you know, because it's not using metal, but it does feel well built. The metallic paint to the back does make it look better than most phones in this segment. The quality is good, no creaking issues. The buttons feel tactile. As far as in-hand use goes, weighing in at around 135 grams and with a thickness of 8.35 millimeters, the 5A does feel nice in hand. The 70 millimeter width means this phone's quite nice for single-handed usage too. Now, well, I'm not gonna go in depth into placements. Make sure you check out our unboxing video for that. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. I'm still gonna point out a few things worth mentioning. For starters, the 5A doesn't sport a fingerprint scanner. Number two, an IR blaster is present though, so you can control air conditioners, TVs and whatnot. Number three, there is support for GeoVolt TE, and number four, there's a secondary noise cancelling microphone. Hey Samsung, worth noting, 5,000 buck phone, secondary noise cancelling microphone. Anyway, the cellular reception and call quality were great. And number five, audio via the headphone jack's acceptable. The audio via the rear facing speaker is reasonably loud. I hate the placement because it gets muffled very easily, especially when placed on a bed or something, you know. There have been times where I did miss my alarm because of that. Anyway, another minor issue worth mentioning is that the front edges are sharp. Now that's something we've not seen on phones for a while, and they kind of take some getting used to. And even after getting used to it, it does definitely take something away as far as ergonomics is concerned. But overall, for the price, Xiaomi's build quality is excellent. Now the reason why the Redmi 5A has a 70mm width, you know, making it single-hand usage friendly, is the fact that it sports a 5-inch display. Xiaomi is using IPS LCD technology here. The resolution is 720p, which when spread over 5 inches results in a pixel density of about 300 pixels per inch. It's not great, but you can't really complain given the price bracket. The viewing angles seem excellent and the display seems reasonably bright. It also looks really saturated. Xiaomi does provide an option to tone it down. Again, for the price, Xiaomi's done an excellent job here. Now, underneath the hood, the Redmi 5A, just like the Redmi 4A before it, is powered by the Snapdragon 425 chip. Now, this is a quad-core chip, 4 A53 cores, coupled with an Adreno 308 GPU, 2 gigs of RAM, 16 gigs of onboard storage. The performance here is okay. For regular day-to-day stuff like checking mails and social media, the 5A had no issues. Yes, it does take a little longer than say the Mi A1 to load up an app or two, but it is quite consistent. No weird crashes, quite stable. MIUI 9 does enhance the experience. It's quite well optimized and stuff like quick switch work flawlessly here. Split screen multitasking is also present and accounted for, but given the limited RAM, 2 gigs and the hardware underneath it, it is a little jittery at times. As far as gaming goes, the Redmi 5A fared really well with casual games, but load up something graphically intensive and it struggles. But that was to be expected, right, given the 5,000 rupee asking price. There's also support for features like Second Space that lets you split your phone into segregated spaces for home and work, and Dual Apps that lets you do things like retain two WhatsApp accounts, one for each SIM maybe. For a look at all the features that MIUI 9 brings with it, do check out our dedicated video on the same. I'll leave a link in the description below. Now, all this is powered by a 3000 mAh battery, which happens to be 120 mAh lower than what's found on the Redmi 4A. And I'm not a fan of the reduced battery capacity. That said, the battery life isn't all that bad. In the five days that I've used this phone as my primary device, I've not once had to plug it in before the end of the day, no matter what I was doing. You know, if it was light to moderate usage at end of the day with a healthy 35-40% juice left, on an intense day, I'd end the day with 5-10% juice left. Given the increase in weight and almost the same thickness as its predecessor, I'd have liked to see at least a small bump in battery capacity, especially since they've not really upgraded the internals either. Now, talking about battery, the charge times are really, really ridiculously slow. If you do end up running out of juice, be prepared to wait well over 2 hours to get this back to 100%. And with that, let's talk cameras. The Redmi 5A sports a 13-megapixel f2.2 camera to the back. I wouldn't even expect images of acceptable quality from a phone in this segment, but I was quite pleasantly surprised. The images are quite decent. Yes, they are over-sharpened, but they look worse without it, so I guess for once it helps here. The dynamic range is okay with HDR turned on. Look at the sunset and the trees. Yes, it did take about 5 seconds to process an HDR image, but then the resulting image was fine. The colors are okay, they're a tad oversaturated. Under low light, the image quality again wasn't too bad, at least not as bad as I expected it to be, especially when we consider the price. You know, I keep saying we consider the price, but then again, the USP of this phone, the biggest selling point of this phone is that 5,000 rupee price tag. So sorry if I sound redundant, but I need to keep saying considering the price because that is what this is about, right? Anyway, yes, the images do look dark and noisy, but most images are usable and that is quite good, you know, considering the price. Anyway, there's also a 5-megapixel snapper to the front. The selfies again look okay. They're definitely not the sharpest I've come across, not that I expected them to be, but for the occasional social media share, they're definitely very much usable. The colors are acceptable too. As far as video goes, the Redmi 5A can shoot 1080p videos at 30 frames per second. Obviously, there's no stabilization of any sort, hence the jitters that you see. The quality too is average at best. Slightly underexposed, very little detail. But one good thing is that there is no focus hunting issue that we found on a few other Xiaomi budget phones. And with that, we get to the part where we usually talk about price, but then again, I've been talking about price quite a bit on this phone, so for 4,999 rupees, is this phone worth it? As a successor to the Redmi 4A, the Redmi 5A is severely lacking. Xiaomi's not done anything new here. You know, it's more of the same in almost the same package. But given that it's effectively priced an entire 1,000 rupees lesser than the Redmi 4A, it kind of makes it really hard not to recommend this guy. 1,000 rupees is a major factor in this segment. Hell, it's 20% of the cost of the phone. So if you are stuck on a tight budget or if you need a secondary phone that doesn't have to be great, but has to offer you great value, you know, an Android smartphone with the least amount of compromises that will still help you get you through your day-to-day stuff, then the Redmi 5A is definitely for you. The 332 variant, well, at 6999, it is pushing too close to Redmi 4 territory, and for the reasons that I explained in the unboxing, I'd prefer a Redmi 4 over it any day. But the 216 variant, priced at 4999, Xiaomi's just absolutely nailed the pricing on this one, so I'm gonna give this a must buy if you're looking at something in this segment. So what do you guys think? Will you recommend this phone to friends and family? Do you think Xiaomi's done good, or do you feel Xiaomi's pulling a Moto, Lenovo and saturating the market with phones that are kind of competing with themselves? You know, kind of cannibalizing the segment. Let me know what you think in the comments below. So that's it for this video, guys. You know what to do if you hated it, but if you did like it, give it a big, huge thumbs up. And for more content like this, hit that subscribe button down below if you haven't yet. If you've already subscribed, hit that bell icon to make sure you get notified each and every time a new video gets uploaded here on C4E Tech. If anyone you know, friends, family, probably, you know, your dog or anybody, you know, if they have a phone, if they have WhatsApp, if they're on Facebook, share this video with them. You know, if they might be interested in this phone. And that's it. Thanks a lot for watching. Till next time, this here is Ash. You've been watching C4 eTech, and I'm signing off for now. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.